Hi, and welcome back. So in this video, we're going to install this plugin, and then we're going to see what you can do with it. So let me come down here, and I want to copy the name so that I can search for it within my WordPress. So I'll come here into plugins, click on add new, then I'll paste in the name, then I'll install it. Install now. Then I'll activate the plugin. And then if I come down into settings, I can come here and click on Getresponse so that you can see the options for the plugin. The next step is to add the API key. So let's go back to Getresponse. And to get your API key, it's under my account, then integrations, then let's come here to API, and then copy the API, come back here, put it in there, and then save. So once you put in the API key, you can see that a bunch of options will come here. There is also an option for adding the forms within the widgets. And if you go to any page or post, you'll see this. This has been added on your WordPress editor. So you can see all my forms are here. So if you want to display a form, you can just select where you want the form to be. And then you choose the form. So like in this case, if I put the form here, let's just say I put whichever form that is, it will add the shortcode for our form right there. Let me update. Let me go and preview this page and see if a form was added on that page. So you can see it adds this form right here. And if you can remember, we also added this form manually using code. So this has been added using the plugin, and this one has been added using the manual code that we pasted in here earlier in one of the earlier videos. So you can see, if you have the plugin, you can easily add a form into your page. So this will be on every page and every post. And you can just come here and choose one of your forms. And you see, this is why I was saying that it's very important for you to give your forms recognizable names. You can see this is web form. I don't even know which one this is. So when you're creating them, make sure you give them names that you can recognize and names that make sense. At least for this one would make sense. So if I wanted to add this pop-up, I would just click and it will add the shortcode for that pop-up right here. So I don't need this. I'll just delete it and then update. So if you come back here to the plugin settings, so to get to the plugin settings, you saw that you can just go to settings and then get response. So you see here that there's also a widget. You can just drag that widget into any area on your widgets area. So I'm going to the widgets page in a minute. Then subscribe via comments. You can add this option. You can add this, turn it on so that an option will be added for people to subscribe. When people leave a comment, there will be an option for them to subscribe to your list. Then I have a plugin that has a registration page. So if you have a similar thing whereby people register on your website, you can turn on this so that they will have the option to subscribe to your email list. And then once you change anything here, make sure you save. So this is what is available on every page. So in the WordPress editor, this option will be there for you. So you can just click on it and add a form on any page. So this is very nice, and at least it makes working with Getresponse really easy. So the only job that will be fallen on you will be for you to go to Getresponse and create these forms, because all these forms must be taken from GetResponse. They'll be taken from your GetResponse account. The next phase, let's go and see the widgets. So I'll just go to the widgets there. So on the widgets page, if I scroll down, I'm sure I'm going to come across GetResponse. So if I just drag it, let me just put it down here. And then you can choose a form. You can see how easy this is. Just choose a form, okay? And then just with this, if I save, not a pop-up, I want something else. Let me choose this one. Now let me choose this one. I don't know which one they are, so make sure you give yours very sensible names. And now let me come here and then reload this page, and we want to see if we are going to have a contact form down here. So if we scroll, you can see our form is loading. There is our form. So if you want to add your form, this is another way in which you can add it. You'll just drag the GetResponse widget to the widget area where you want to add it. Of course, I don't need this right here, so I'll just delete mine. In this video, we have learned how we can use the GetResponse plugin to add forms in a WordPress website. And the same is true for the other platforms that we saw, such as PrestaShop. Also, if you're using WooCommerce on WordPress, and then those Drupal and Joomla. So if you're using any of those platforms, you can just install the respective modules or the respective plugins to give you the same functionality, such as this. So once you install the plugin, you see it comes with a widget. You can just drag a widget and then select the form that you want. And also, in every post and page, you'll come across this on the WordPress editor. So once you create your forms on GetResponse, you will be able to access them right here once you connect the plugin using WordPress and GetResponse. And you'll need your API key. So once you put the API key, all this will come into play for you as well. So that's it for this video. And in the next section, we are going to start looking at messages. We are going to look at all of this. So I will see you when we start looking at these messages, where we are going to create newsletters and we're going to see how you can send out newsletters to your contacts. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, make sure you let me know and I will see how to assist you. Until next time, see you.